गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू गुरुदेव ऑनलाइन क्लास। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट अ पोयम नो मैन आर फॉरन रिटन बाय जेम्स किरकम एंड यस्टरडे वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द ब्रीफ डिस्क्रिप्शन अबाउट जेम्स किरकम दैट ही वाज अ प्रोलिफिक पोएट एंड नॉट ओनली अ पोएट ही वाज अ ट्रांसलेटर एंड ही वाज ऑल्सो अ ट्रैवल राइटर who has written more than 30 books and from the age of 6 he started to write small verses or poems and in this message the poet James Kirkup is going to give the message about universal brotherhood. It means the entire world is our own family. And in the first stanza we discussed that James Kirkup is telling, remember my dear children, or remember that all or no men are strange and no countries are foreign, because beneath uniformity, from internally, from inside, we are all are one. We don't have any discrimination from inside. We have the same functions, we have the same body, we have the same organs in our blood, in our body, the same blood is flowing like the people of other countries have. And we are going to walk on the same land like the people of another country, they are going to walk. And in the second stanza, the poet James Kirkup is telling about even the countrymen of another country, they too are aware of the sun, water, air, and if we live in a peaceful harvest, we can live very comfortably and happily. If there is a peace in a country, the people can do their work properly. Especially he is giving much stress to farming. If there is no war, if there are no discriminations, if there are no difference of opinion, the war could not take place. If the war takes place, the people may die of starving, the people may die of hungry, and the people of the another country, they too have the same hands just like us, and whatever they are going to write, we are going to read, and the labors just like our own, they too do hard work. Like the people of our country do hard work to survive, even the people of another country, they are going to do hard work for survival. So these are the two stanzas we discussed yesterday. Now we will discuss the remaining two stanzas and what the James Kirkup is telling, or how he is going to give the message about universal brotherhood by the help of these two stanzas. Okay, just observe your textbook, my dear students. Remember, they have eyes like ours that wake or sleep, and strength that can be won by love. In every land is common life that all can recognize and understand. Let us remember, whenever we are told to hate our brothers, it is ourselves that we shall dispose, betray, condemn. Remember, we who take arms against each other, it is the human earth that we defy. Our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence of air that is everywhere our own. Remember, no men are foreign and no countries strange. See, remember that they have eyes like ours that wake or sleep. Similarity. The poet is comparing the people of our one country to another country. What is that similarity? Even the people of another country, they have eyes like us. Just like we have the two eyes, whether the people of another country may have three or four eyes. No, they too have the same eyes, which wakes or which sleeps. See, they have eyes like us that wake or sleep. They too have the same eyes from which they are going to see, from which they are going to sleep, from which they are going to wake. okay, and strength that can be won by love, a very beautiful line. See here, and strength that can be won by love, a very wonderful line has been written by James Kirkup. What is telling? Love can be only won by love. If you want to get love from another, you cannot force someone to love you. You cannot show a gun. You cannot hold a knife in your hand. You cannot force him to show his love and affection and care towards you. If you want to love someone, if you are expecting love from others, what you have to do? You too have to love. So he is telling, and strength that can be won by love. He is telling, everything can be won. If you are going to show love, if you are going to show mercy, if you are having a love with each other, even though you belong to some another country, some another tribe, some another religion, some another caste, if you show your love to him, he too will show the love. So everything, each and everything can be won by the love. Strength doesn't matter, my dear students. If you have a strength, it doesn't mean that you are very powerful, so he or she may love you. If in your heart you have a love, the people will attract towards you. That is what the J.M. Kirkup wants to tell. Strength can be won by love. Only love can be gained by love. You cannot force someone to show the love by having the supreme powers. If you have a gun in your hand, you cannot tell him, I have a gun in my hand, you love me or else I will shoot you. This is not happening, my dear student. So everything can be won by the love. And strength that can be won by love, in every land is common life that all can recognize and understand. In every land is common life. In every land, in the sense, land in the sense country, continent or subcontinent. In every country or in every land, there is a common life. There is a common life. Here, common life in the sense human life. The survival of the human being. So here the poet is telling, in every land is a common life that all can recognize and understand. Every human being is similar. Every human being is same. The only thing is, we have to recognize and understand. We have to recognize and understand. It means we have to respect. We have to respect the feeling of each other. We have to give respect to the what? Some different kind of a preferences, choice of others. Just because I don't like the color black, if someone is going to wear the black, we should not hate him just because I don't like the color. We have to respect the differences. We have to respect the choices. We have to respect the opinions. We have to respect the preferences, tastes of others. Okay. So in every land there is a common life that we all recognize and understand. It means all the country have a same common life, but the only thing is we have to recognize and we have to understand the feeling of the another countryman. Okay, last but not the least stanza. Let us remember, whenever we are told to hate our brothers, it is ourselves that we shall despise, betray and condemn. Okay, so the poet is telling, remember, he is going to tell to the readers. What is going to tell? Remember. Let us remember, whenever we are told to hate our brothers. Let us remember that whenever we are told to hate our brothers. Brothers in the sense, the fellow countrymen, the people of another country. So you may have seen in WhatsApp videos or YouTube, there are some of the people who try to influence you to do some of the negative things. The best example I will take, Osama bin Laden. He was a terrorist. He killed thousands of people. Right? The best example, WTO, World Trade Organization or World Trade Center. He blasted it, right? So you may see, you may listen his speeches many a times, or the main work or the main intention of that Osama bin Laden speech is to spread the hateism. Spread the hateism. So what he was doing? He was influencing the people to hate each other. He was influencing that one countryman has to kill the other fellow countrymen because they do not belong to our religion. They do not belong to our caste or tribe. So this was influenced. So what the poet is telling, whenever we are told to hate our brothers, even the fellow countrymen are our brothers. We have to treat them as our brothers because although they belong to some another country, although they have their own choices, but from inside, yes, very good. From inside, we are all are same. So for that reason, the poet is telling, we have to show or we have to love our brothers. Whenever we are told to hate our brothers, it is ourselves that we dispose, betray and condemn. So suppose in your lifespan, during your life, if some of the person may tell you to hate your brother, so actually if you influence by that person, if you heeded the words of that person, if you listen to the word of that person who is telling you to hate your brothers or hate our brothers, actually what you are going to do, if you are going to listen to such kind of idiotic peoples, what we are doing, it is ourselves. If you are going to listen to such people and if you are going to hate your brothers, what you are going to do, it is ourselves that we dispose. We are not going to hate them. Actually, we are hating ourselves because a negativity is gone already in your mind. A negative thought has already gone in your mind and you are accepting that negativity. So the poet is telling, if someone tells you to hate someone, you are not hating that person. Actually, you are hating yourself. That it means that we shall dispose. Dispose means banish or disown. You are not giving respect. By listening to that person, you are not giving to the respect to the person, the one who have told you to hate. Actually, you are disrespecting yourself. You are hating yourself. You are not only you are disrespecting, not only you became disloyal or disowned, but also you are betraying. What is the meaning of betray? Cheating. You are cheating your parents. You are cheating your country. You are cheating the government. You are cheating the constitution. Because our constitution has, whether it has tell us, it has told us to harm each other, to hate each other. Even our constitution tells the same message, right? We all are one. We all are one. So just by hating someone else, you are not only hating them, you are hating yourself, you are vanishing, you are cheating, you are betraying yourself, and you are what? Condemned. What is the meaning of condemn? Dislike. You are disliking the preferences, choice, religions, caste. You are disliking them because in every country, people have their own rights to follow their own rituals. Just because we have some own set of rituals, own faiths, it doesn't mean the people of another country, if they don't have our kind of rituals and faiths, it doesn't mean that they are not good. Am I right? Yes. So, if you are hating some another countryman, it is just like you are banishing yourself, you are betraying or cheating yourself, or you are disliking yourself. Okay. Remember, we who take arms against each other, it is the human earth that we defy. And we who take the arms against each other, arms, weapons. What it means, if suppose you are heeding the words of such peoples, and because just because your frequency has not matched with the another country people and you have started war by taking the cruel weapons, arms, what may happen? We who take arms against each other, if suppose a country started war with another country, what may happen? What are the effects? Remember, we who take arms against each other, it is the human earth that we defy. If you are going to take weapons, if you are going to take arms to fight with each other, to kill each other, to harm each other, to do damage each other, actually what we are going to do? We are spoiling, we are defiling the, what we are defiling the earth. Defile means spoiling or making something impure. The best example, Hiroshima and Nagasaki, when the Germany has put the atomic bomb, what happened? Thousands, lakhs of people died, and even till today there are some of the places where you cannot cultivate. The land has become impure, it has become totally waste. You cannot cultivate it just because we human impured it. We human spoiled the land for our own benefits, for our own interest, for our own advantages, for our own benefits. We started the war, and what is the effect? People will die, and we are going to make our earth impure, the soil of our earth impure. We who take arms against each other, it is the human earth we defy. Our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence of air that is everywhere our own. Remember, no men are foreign, no countries strange. Our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence of air. See here, our hells of fire and dust is nothing but the evil effects of the war. The evil effects of the war. What the poet is telling? Our hells of fire and dust. Here, the poet is comparing the after situation of the war. When the war is going to take place, when a war has been taking place from one country to another country in the on the boundary of two countries, after the war, if you see the scenario, if you see the scene, what you may see? You may see green trees, fresh air. What you may see? You may see smoke. You may see the trees which are being cut down, blood, halfly torn dead bodies. So these are the evil effects of the war. Our hells of fire and dust. So that fire, the fire which has been ignited by the people, the fire which has been ignited by the fellow countrymen, if we start the war, that fire is compared to the hell of the fire. To the fire of the hell. The fire of the hell. Because in Puranas we will come to know that if we go to hell, the people are going to die, or the Almighty God, if you are not going to do good deeds, they are going to burn us. Our soul is going to get burned by the fire of the hell. So that fire, the fire of the hell, is compared when someone is going to start the war, that scenario is compared to hell. That scenario is compared, or that situation, or that scene is compared to the scene of the hell. Our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence of air. Means, if you are going to do war, if you are going to launch some atomic weapons, some of the bombs, naturally, the air, the innocence air. See, such a wonderful word it is. Innocence. The air is very innocent. Why? Because the air, when whether it has any gender, whether the air have any religion, whether it have any caste. Oh, this is Hindu, I am Hindu, I have to what provide my what air to only to Hindus or Christians or Muslims or Jainas. No, it doesn't have any religion. It is very innocent. It is very innocent. The air is filled with the innocence. It don't know any boundaries. It don't know any barriers. You cannot hold the air because air is not a property of one country, right? Whether air which is going from another country, it reaches India, whether the people of India will tell you have been blown from another country, you just go back? No, my dear students. So for that reason, the poet is telling the air is very innocent. So when someone is going to start the war, what will happen? The air, the innocent air is going to become impure. It is going to what? Contaminate. The air is going to get contaminated by the poisonous gases, poisonous things. So the poet is telling not to do war. If you should not do war, what you have to do? You have to respect the feeling of each other. Each other in the sense, you have to show the respect to the people of the another countryman. Okay. See, our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence of air that is everywhere our own. For air doesn't belong to any one single person or one single country or one single religion. It is everyone's. The air belongs to everyone. We have the legal right on the air. We cannot tell that don't take breath. If you have gone to somebody's home, if you get the air, whether the owner of the house can tell, you are standing in my home, so whatever the air is going to blow, that air belongs to me. You don't breathe it, you don't inhale it. Whether you can tell like that? No, my dear students, because air, it is our own. We have the rights. Not only for the air, for the sunlight, we have the right. Each and every human being have the right. Water, the rivers, we have our right. The light, we have our right. Just like the same air, we have the right. Of air that is everywhere our own. Remember, no men are foreign, no countries are strange. If you are going to show the respect towards each other, there will be no war, and when there will be no war, there will be peaceful everywhere, and when there is a peace, there will be universal brotherhood. When you are not going to harm each other, when you are going to show respect, when you are going to show the care, when you are going to share the affection, when you are going to love towards each other, in every country, there will be a harmony, there will be peace, and when there is a peace, automatically the universal brotherhood will be developed. The beautiful Sanskrit phrase Vasudeva Kutumbakam may take place. Okay, so by telling this, we will conclude this lesson, this poem. If you find any difficulty, my dear students, you may ask in the interaction class. Thank you.